Hey guys, welcome to our channel Coders Arcade. So recently I've been working on a new playlist, which is C programming for problem solving. So if you have not seen it till now, I'll give the link in the description below, or you can click on the top right I button and have a look. In that playlist, I have covered basic theoretical part. Now I am going to start executing programs. So for that purpose, I'll be using VS Studio Code or Visual Studio Code. So what is Visual Studio Code? So basically, Visual Studio Code is an IDE or integrated development environment where we can write our programs, compile them, execute them, and view the result or output. Now the question arises, why only use Visual Studio Code? Why not any other IDE? In earlier days, we were using Turbo C editor for running C programs. But in today's modern world, there are many good options which are better than Turbo C, like VS Code or Visual Studio Code, Eclipse, NetBeans, CodeBlocks, etc. These IDEs provide a ton of features like IntelliSense, which will tell you even the smallest mistakes you make while writing your code, which makes coding life a lot simpler by saving time and energy. Okay, so now let me tell you why we are using VS Code in this case when there are many other IDEs available. So here, first I am going to open my Google Chrome. Here I am going to show you why we are using Visual Studio Code in this case. So here I am going to type, if you search here, best IDE for C programming in 2021. And then press enter, then you will see here at the very top, it says Visual Studio Code. Why Visual Studio Code? Because Visual Studio Code supports not only C, but many other different languages such as Python, Java, C++, and many more. Even you can do web development on VS Code. So this is the reason that we will be using Visual Studio Code. So first of all, to install Visual Studio Code, you need to search download VS Code or Visual Studio Code, anything you can write, and press enter. So there will be first link. You just need to click on this first link, download Visual Studio Code, which is the code.visualstudio.com. This is the original site for Visual Studio Code. You need to click on this and then you need to click on this button. Because I'm using Windows, I will click on this. If you have Linux or Mac, you can download it from these two links. But in this case, we are using Windows. That is why we'll be clicking here. After clicking, your download will automatically start. So now it's prompting me where to save my setup. So in this case, I'll be saving my setup at desktop. I'll select desktop here and then I'll press save. See, it started downloading and it completed download. So now I'll just simply click on to my VS Code setup and wait for it to prompt. Here, now that we have opened our setup, you need to click on to I accept the agreement. And then you need to click on to this button, which is next. And here in this case, it is showing me the default path. It is fine. You can use this path only. But in my case, all my files are in my D drive. That is why I'm going to change my location and I'll change my location. Here I'll save it, and after choosing your location, just click next. You don't need to click anything here, just press next. Here you don't need to click on to any other options, just leave it as it is. But in my case, I need a desktop icon, so I'll click on to this desktop icon and then I'm going to press next and then install. And the installation is finished. Now this launch Visual Studio Code is checked and then I'll press finish. So once it is opened, it will look like this. And here I'll just give you a brief introduction to Visual Studio Code. So on the left hand side, as you can see, these are all the options that you get. So these are all the main options that we are going to use in our programming, in our future videos. So first of all, this one is the Explorer button. Then this is the Search button. Now this is the Source Control button. And this is the Debugging button. And this is the Extension button. So right now we have only installed IDE, in which we can write our C program. To run the C program, we also need to download the compiler as well. So again, I'm going to go to my Chrome, and here in new tab, I am going to search for C program in VS Code. And then I'm going to press enter. Here the site will be code.visualstudio.com. This is the main site. You need to open it. And once it is open, you need to go into C++. Now, after going, you need to scroll down a little bit. And here you can see this is the MingW64, which is our compiler for C programming. So this is the link here. You can click onto this link and it will open it into a new tab. And here our download will begin shortly. It asked me the location where I want to download. So in this case, I am again going to download on my desktop. So I'll click on my desktop and then press save. And I'll wait for my setup to download. My setup is already downloaded. I'm going to click onto the setup and we'll press yes. And this is the MingW setup installation wizard. I'm going to click on to next. Here you don't need to do anything, you just need to press next, and then you need to check your destination folder where you want to save. So in this case, again I am going to change my location, but in your case you can leave it as it is. I'll click on to browse and select my location. Okay, so here this is my location, and then I'm going to press next. And once I press next, it will start installing and it will download the required files and will install in your PC. So this is a little bit lengthy part. I'll skip it for you. Okay, so now it has been installed. I'll click on to next and then I'll click on to finish. Now, one of the most important thing that you need to remember when you download MingW, you need to add your MingW folder's path into your environment variables. So first of all, you need to go on to the location where you have installed. In your case, it will be in C drive and program 86, and here your MingWG folder will be present. But in my case, it is installed in D. That is why I'm going to my location where I have installed my MingW. So here you need to go on to your MingW32 folder, and here, first of all, you need to open bin, and this is all the exe files that your compiler will require while you compile your C program. So for that, we need to add the environment variables to our system. So this is our main exe file that which will be executed every time we compile our program, which is GCC. Click on this address bar. You need to copy this path by pressing Ctrl plus C and then minimizing it. Right click on this PC and go to properties. When you are inside your properties, you need to click on to advanced system settings. When you click on to advanced system settings, you will see a window pop up. In this window, this is the system properties window. On this window, you need to click onto your environment variables. So after clicking onto your environment variables, you need to select path. And here in this path, you need to click on to edit. Now here you need to paste the location that you already copied. So I'm going to click on to new and I'm going to press Ctrl plus V and I'll paste the location that we copied, that bin location, that bin folder location that we copied for MingW. And press enter and then press OK. Here also in system variables, I'll update my path as well. So I'll click on to edit and click on to new. And here I'm going to paste my path and then I'm going to press OK. Here also I'm going to press OK. And then again press OK. So now this, now your setup for your IDE and your compiler for C is complete. Now you're ready to start executing a program in C. So for that, first I'm going to click onto my Explorer and you can either click onto this open folder or you can click onto file and you can click onto open folder. Now you need to select location where you want to make a folder for your C programs. I'll go into my desktop and I've already made my folder as C programming. You can make a new folder here by pressing Ctrl plus Shift plus N and this will create a new folder for you. And then you can rename your folder C project or any name you want and then press Enter and press Select Folder. So we are into our folder. So now that we have created a new folder, which is C project. Now this will be a main project in which we will be writing our all the programs. In our Explorer, this is our folder that we created, which is C project. Now here on the right hand side of your name of your folder, you can see some buttons here. This is the new file button. This is the new folder button. This is the refresh Explorer button and this is the minimize button or collapse folder button. So I'm going to click on to new file here and I'm going to name this file as main.c and press enter. So now we have created our first C file. Now I'm going to write here my program. So you don't need to understand the logic behind this program. I'm just writing this program just to check if my Visual Studio Code has been installed properly. But if you want to know the logic behind this code, I'll be giving a link in the description below. So that by clicking on to that link, you can watch one of our playlist, which is on C programming. Okay, so now let's begin. I'm going to write here hash include stdio.h. Then I'm going to create my main function. So I'll be writing main. As you can see here, Visual Studio Code has given me a suggestion. This is what I was talking about, the IntelliSense thing. So this is what IntelliSense is doing. It will auto-complete my code and will suggest and will predict the code which I am going to write. So this is very handy in this IDE. Now because of this, Visual Studio Code is one of the top IDEs that you can use in 2021. Because not only in C, it supports many other languages such as Python, Java, and so on. Okay, now I'm going to press enter and see. Code is completed. I'm just going to edit this code. So I'm going to write printf. And in parenthesis, in quotes, I'm going to write hello world. And then semicolon. So after completing my code, I'm going to press on to terminal and then new terminal. I'll just wait for terminal to get ready. And here I'm going to write gcc main.c. So you see gcc here, gcc is a compiler. And after compiling, as you can see here, a.exe file has been created.
So this a.exe file is the executable file for the output. So I'm going to write a and then press tab, and it will auto complete my .a.exe and press enter. See, it printed hello world. So my program is running properly, and this is the a.exe file and this is the main.c file. Let us check it again. So I'm going to write gcc main.c. First I'm going to compile and then I'm going to write a.exe. So see, it has printed hello world. So our program is running.
So this is all about this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you like the video, and if you like it, then tell us in the comment section below. If you have any doubts, then post them in the comment section. I will definitely try to clear those doubts. Also, like, share and subscribe to our channel Coders Arcade and press the bell icon so that you will get a notification when we post our new video. Thank you. Happy learning.